Good morning, good morning. I don't know how I'm going to do this page. I think I started off yesterday just like this. There are some... how did Allie Edwards do hers? I've already forgotten. All right, I have the back of this dude, and I purposely have not filled it in and closed up these gaps. Number one, I don't have sequins. I don't think I do. I could take a small hole punch and just poke a whole bunch of red and green paper, which is probably what I'll end up doing, as long as it's double-sided, and fill it in, and then close, fuse the top closed. And I don't think if I have that as a shaker, or my version of a shaker, I don't have to include this in my spread for today, which means I'm okay with adding like divider pages. So this might be the right divider page right here. So divide that up. I could use this, and let's see if I have anything in here I might want to use. Now I have a large page protector here. I was going to do a calendar page because I always like doing a calendar page, but really and truly, my events have slowed down dramatically this year, so it's going to be a boring calendar page. Mrs. Claus's was much more fuller than mine. Now, hold on. This is not going to be my divider page. Now this is, I see some people saying they don't like too many clear pages together. Well, I have two. That's okay. This is going to be considered clear. But I might take the back of these circles and do some historical things about Van Gogh. Because yesterday I went to the museum in Columbia, downtown Columbia, to the Van Gogh exhibit, which was fabulous. Fabulous. If you're near Columbia, South Carolina, which I don't think too many of you are, but look at this. I guess I had forgotten about this picture of his. I love that. I don't think I've ever seen that one. It was done in 1887. Well, here's probably why I haven't seen it. It's on loan from the Denver Art Museum. But I mean, that almost looks Christmassy to me. And then, of course, iconic self-portrait, 1887, from the Wadsworth Museum in Hartford, Connecticut. But, and Curti, you're going to laugh at me. That's okay. I could be laughed at. Look what I got. It's a zipper pouch. Can't have too many. Okay. Inside joke, you can't have too many zipper pouches in my world. I don't know why I love them. I make them, I buy them. It's kind of crazy. And Mr. Victor Crafter, if you've watched any old videos, you've discovered this already too. Good morning. Hello. Thank you for always leaving a nice comment. And anybody else that's watching, hello. Welcome. I don't do a very good job of, and this is a Metropolitan Museum of Art product, which, have I been there a dozen times? Yes. Oh man, what a great card right there. Woohoo! That could go in a Hobonichi. Holy moly. Did I pay that much for this? Ay, ay, ay. A fool and his money is soon parted. I had to write my husband a check yesterday, a very large check, from the proceeds of selling my mom and dad's house. That went automatically into my checking account, but we're combining that money and a little bit from our savings to get the beach house. And I told him I needed all that money back because I found my next car. I said, that check I wrote you yesterday, I need all that back. It'll probably take that much to buy this car. It's just a joke. It is a BMW convertible 640, I think was the number. It is gorgeous. Bright red. Gorgeous. Okay, okay. Sidetrack. Sorry, sorry. Squirrels, squirrels. Anyhow, this exhibit was lovely. But I could put facts about Van Gogh on these circles on other paper. Like journal here. And somehow come up with pictures to go here. Now, I saw one lady make a book and she put it in a page protector. What size pockets do I have? I have, I guess I can make pockets of any size that I want, right? Okay, I know I have more of these. Where are the rest of these? There we go. I could, like, mount these all on paper. Oh, wait a second. Okay, wait a second, wait a second. This one is horizontal, so I could do a piece of paper on a book. There's not a horizontal. I guess it depends on how many I have. But I would stick the base of the book on the inside of the pocket. Okay, that's what I'm going to do. Huh. I have more horizontals than I have. Hold on, somebody's at my door. That was the little girl next door. She comes and says hi to me every morning. She is so cute. Okay, so I'm going to put facts here. Some kind of pocket here. Book. And we're going to Van Gogh this Christmas up. That's a new word. Van Gogh it. A verb. A verb. But you hear tiptoe through the tulips here? A dog. All right. All right. Theoretically, I'm going to fast forward this a little bit because I'm sure it won't work the first go around here for me. And now I need to come up with something in the top pocket. Or do I do? Since I have some horizontal ones, I could trim those down a little bit. I didn't mean to print the borders on these things, but I did. Huh, okay. Fast forward.
It's the most wonderful time of the year. With the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year. It's the happiest season of all. With those holiday greetings and gay happy meetings when friends come to call. It's the happiest season of all. There'll be parties for hosting, marshmallows for toasting, and caroling out in the snow. There'll be scary ghost stories and tales of the glories of Christmases long, long ago. It's the most wonderful time of the year. There'll be much mistletoeing and hearts will be glowing when loved ones are near. It's the most wonderful time of the year. Scary ghost stories and tales of the glories of Christmases long, long ago. It's the most wonderful time of the year.
much mistletoeing, and hearts will be glowing when loved ones are near. It's the most wonderful time. Yes, the most wonderful time. Oh, the most wonderful time of the year.
Tad messy. Somehow, I went to the grocery store this morning, quick before I started filming. And somehow, I have grease on my hands from like the back trunk of the car. And I'm finding it in the weirdest places transferring. Okay, so this is a little sloppy. You know, I watch these ladies on their videos and they're so precise and so this and so that. It seems a little tedious. Now I know why it's tedious. That's not easy to do. I commend you, ladies. Alrighty. I need to be less critical because everything I think is bad is good. All right. So I had a divider here. Oh, dear. I need to put a circle there on this side now of blue. Lord knows where that blue paper is. I have scraps theoretically in a separate envelope. All right. I will cover that up. And I didn't know how I was going to use this. I just got fast. And mine are not precise. Okay. So I added my end frame. I added, kind of was going with the snowflake on the burlap paper because it kind of picks up the frames, but I think I'm going to trim off this white. I don't, that's too stark. In fact, I'm going to do that right now. So, the exhibit was nothing like what I had been told. I don't know. The person that told me all the information about it, I don't know. I think they went to a different exhibit. It had, maybe I shouldn't be so critical. Maybe I saw the wrong thing. It was the people that the influencers of Van Gogh. And I find that really interesting because there's YouTube influencers now. That's what they call them, I think. That's the latest term or a term. And these were his influencers. He didn't have YouTube. But I did not know that Van Gogh was such a studier of other people's work. Now, he was a compulsive personality type person. And today, I think he would be labeled as bipolar or one of those labels. And it did, it said, I mean, what I read on Wikipedia, which I know is not always a right type of source, but it said there that he committed suicide. Well, at the exhibit yesterday, they are not ruling out yet if it was self-inflicted. He was already had checked himself into the asylum. But it was, he had notebooks of, in fact, this page right here is it's on old paper and it's photographed of old paper, so it came out orange on my stuff. But he did studies and he wrote impulsively, compulsively, all the things that a certain person influenced him. Why, what, and what strokes or what colors or what theme or whatever. And he had notebooks like that, much like our notebooks today. I thought that was fascinating. There is some of that grease. I don't know where it came. Anyhow, I have vellum in here. It really is foggy looking to me. And it's transferring spilled paint on my desk here. But okay. So I did not journal yet. I have space to journal right there. And I think I will journal on some other kind of paper about what I did. Or maybe I'll just do it in a, I'll just do it in a different color ink. And that's why I love these pens. maybe the name of some of his influencers, which I have to go back on my pictures and look. So anyhow, that was a, there were probably five or six of his paintings. This is one of his influencers. Self-portrait that he did. It was fascinating. Oh, you know what? Oh, this one is a postcard. I love this one. It's titled Edge of a Wheat Field with Poppies. I love that. I love this. The green, and that's when he started going into more of his strokes. 1887, so that was getting towards the end. Yeah, that was 3 years before he died. Oh, there's grease there too. Luckily, I'm going to cut off that white border. So anyhow, I got a couple postcards that are going to go in my Hobonichi, most likely. Carti, don't laugh at me. I over-purchased Christmas. Now, I'll save it from year to year. But I'm finding that I'm not using any of these ephemera pieces that I bought. That's why I use this. I wanted to try to remind myself in the middle of a Van Gogh exhibit that it was still Christmas. I'm in a Christmas album. But we had the best time yesterday. We had a nice lunch. What kind of sandwich did I have? I had a BLT and a bacon, lettuce, and tomato and avocado on this luscious bread, which I am not a fan of bread with seeds. If I was supposed to have been born a bird, I would have been born a bird. Obviously, I'm not a bird because I couldn't fly. I couldn't get off the ground. There's too much in the middle of me to get off the ground. And then I had some soup that was, what was that soup? It was tomato soup with tomato bisque with spinach and feta cheese. Oh, it was delicious. Anyhow, we decided that group might get together. There were six of us might get together and do something once a month. Art influenced. Anyhow, that would be fun. I'll have to do it when I'm in town. We're closing the beginning of next week some point. I told my husband, Monday. No, dear. Maybe towards the end of next week. That would work better with his schedule. Since we both have to do it. But anyhow. Okay. Love this. Gotta fix one circle. Oh, you know what? Hold everything. I knew I dropped a circle. Okay. Here's another plus for the tape. That I don't like, that I use all the time. So, everybody, thanks for watching. Have a great day. I can't believe it's Friday. This week has flown by. I guess because I've been super busy packing and whatever. I gotta go wash my hands. I didn't even realize they were dirty. My circles are not perfect, but oh well. Neither am I. I have lots of flaws. My stupid acetate got dirty. Oh, okay. Stop. Thanks for watching. Bye.